What's up everyone, Alan Morrow here and welcome to today's video. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I go about creating a nice, lush, creamy sounding saw pad for your trance tracks or any tracks that you kind of want. And if you stick around to the end of the video, I'll show you some sort of techniques that I use to kind of soften some of those somewhat harsher, higher frequencies within the saw that you can sometimes get. So before we get into the video, if you are interested in tips and tricks like this in the future, then be sure to hit that subscribe and notification bell so you don't miss any of the future videos. And if you are looking for more in-depth tutorials to help you with your trance productions, then be sure to head over to alanmorrowstudios.com. And there is lots of tutorials, start to finish courses, sound design, creativity, everything you can think of to help you with your trance productions. So let's get into the video. So what I've got here is just an instance of Zebra, which I'm going to use to create today's saw. Now, there's many different ways that you can do this. So this is just one way that I would go about doing it. You can use your own synths. You can modulate different parameters and stuff like that. There's so many different instances of it. But what I've got here is a pad pattern, a pad progression. Just something simple for us to put the pad actually to. Now, the way that I'm going to use this is I'm going to be using seven voices, use your words, Alan, seven voices for this, like the original supersaw. Now, the way to do this inside Zebra, or the way that I do it in Zebra, is you can't just go and select seven voices, and there's actually pros to not doing it this way in here as well, which you'll see in a few minutes. So the way to do this is I'm going to go and do dual on the first one, so two voices on the first oscillator two. I'm going to do another two there, oscillator three, another two voices, and then oscillator four is going to be one voice. So we've got seven voices there, seven saw waves to work with. Now, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to detune all of these by around about 20, something like that. Have a play around, see what works best for your sound and the progression that you've got and whatnot and how many notes you're playing. But with this, I'm just going to start to detune these. And I'm gonna leave that last one. Right, now, what I'm also gonna do here is I'm gonna just change the attack and release times, so it's more of a pad shape. Let me bring this right down as well, it's way too loud. Okay, so very typical, very standard stuff there. Now, where this really comes into its own is I'm going to duplicate as well so you can hear the difference that this kind of makes, is I'm going to detune these to themselves in very small increments with the fine tune. So if I've duplicated that, let's open up another version of it. So it's the same thing again. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get these fine tunes, and I'm going to change them in very, very small increments, left or right, up or down, however you want to look at it. So let's play this through, and when I'm doing it, I'm going to use the shift because I've got to do it in very small amounts, and that's the way to sort of do it in here. So I'm just going to play this, and you'll see how much I'm doing it by here. It's very, very small amount. You obviously play around, see what works for you, but you'll start to hear how it makes a much more lush pad sound. If you go too far with it, it starts to sound a bit weird. So very, very small amounts you want to do it. And this is why it's sometimes good to have different oscillators so that you can do this with it. You know, if it's just the one or two, you don't get as much control as you're getting right now. So again, I'm going to leave that last one. Now that I've got these, what I want to show you here is, now I'm just going to flip between the two so you can kind of hear the original one without this fine-tuned tweaks and this one. So you can hear how they sort of sound and how that makes a difference to the sound. So here we go. This is the original one. It sounds quite it's got a bit, it's quite harsh, you know. So much smoother sort of sound there. Now, what I want to show you next before I start adding in effects and stuff like that is you can actually soften this up a little bit more. Now, if I show you oscillator one, so we can isolate it so you can hear it a little bit better. If I just play oscillator one, always make sure to click on this, because even when you click on this, it doesn't always jump to it in Zebra. Now, what you want to be able to do here is you want to be able to slightly edit the waveform. So you need a synth that's going to allow you to do that with this, for this technique. But if I just play this, it's got a little bit of sort of harsh brittleness to the top end. Now, if I just come in here, pull these in a tiny little bit, it really kind of softens that top end a little bit. If I show you the difference now, I'll flip between this one and this one. So this is, first one's the edited one. These are just the waveforms here within this. So if I flip between the two, you'll hear it. So this is the softened one. You can hear this over YouTube, but just softens that top end just a little bit. Might have gone a little bit too far with it. Have a bit of a play around, see what works best for you. This one here is a little bit sort of, I guess, more fuzzy. And this one's a little bit smoother and a bit creamier on the top. This is just one oscillator. So what you can do is you can go into some others and have a bit of a play around with them. So let's go into, say, maybe oscillator two. Again, another saw. What I'm going to do this time is I'm going to soften it up a little bit. Now, in Serum and stuff like that, they actually already have these in the analog section, I think it is. They have these waveforms like this anyway. And you can kind of smooth these off a little bit. So again, I'll show you. So if I just go click on this, select, smooth the selected. So this is a slightly smoother sound again. So it goes from this to this. Now again, you can play around very small amounts, so you just dial in how much of sort of that high end frequency stuff you want. I hope you can hear this over YouTube, because it is a small amount, but these little small tweaks make a big difference. So you can do it with all three or all four, whatever you want to do. I'm going to do it with just two for now, so I've kind of got a bit of a middle ground between the, all of them. Let's actually go in and do it slightly with these ones as well. So oscillator three, go to here and just tiny small amount. And then oscillator four, I'll do it with that one as well. So let's play them all together. Now, what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to duplicate this so you can have a little listen to how it sounds, compare the two, A, B them. So if I go back to this again, and in this one, I'm just going to go through and I'm going to flip them all back to the different sounds so you can have a little listen. You don't have to do this. It's a bit of a personal taste thing, I guess. But let's just flip between it. So this is the, I guess, harsher saw. And this is the more rounded sounded one. There we go. So I'll flip between these two so you can hear the difference. Again, you might like the high-endness to it. I'm going to actually add a bit more high into this rounded one anyway. So I just wanted to show you that anyway. Hopefully you can hear it over there, over YouTube. So I'll get rid of that. Second, let's just play this again. Now what I want to do is I want to move into the effects section. So I'm going to add Gonna add, I hope you can see that, yep. I'm gonna add some chorus to this. So I'm gonna bring this down. To kind of smooth it out again a little bit. Kind of nice. Then I'm gonna add in a filter. So different type of filters here, but I'm gonna add a little tiny touch of resonance. Okay, great, cool. So now that I've got that there, what do I wanna add in next? Let's add some reverb. And then what I wanna do after this is I'm gonna add some EQ to the end. And I'm gonna add a little bit of brightness to that top end. So I'm just gonna get quite a wide band like this. So that sounded really nice. Now you could stop here, or as I said before, you can do multiple different things to this. So what I might actually do is go in and widen these a little bit. And then I'm gonna get oscillator 1 and 2, and I'm gonna pan them a little bit as well. Now, if you want to add other little kind of variations to this, and again, you don't have to, you can do stuff like, depending on what synth you're using, you can either do it through the M map in Zebra, or you can do it through like velocity sort of mapping. But inside here, where I've got these little fine tunes here, let me just isolate oscillator 2 a second. Where I've got this fine tune that I've altered before by -0.04. What I can do is either send this to an LFO, or I can have it so I go to something like this M map here, which is gonna basically, each increment that I do, I'll ramp it right up so you can hear the difference. Here it's sort of tuning heavily each note I hit, and you can see along here, moving along as I hit each note, it'll move a lot across. Now this is way too much and I don't want it to do this, but having these little small subtleties in the pitch across the notes, I can really sort of, again, just add a little bit of extra character to it. So the way I'm going to do this, I'm going to change this to say maybe 8 different increments, so it's not as much. Let me just do this. So we go to 8. I don't know why it's... Okay, there we go. So, and I'm going to do very, very small amounts. Now, it's still way too much because I've got this dialed right up here. But if I come down here again and do this, go back to where it was, and again, fine, dial it in. It's just a small amount. That fine tune is going to move around again, just small little amounts each time I hit it. And you can go in and do this with other parameters if you want. Let's just go in and add them all in together. You probably aren't going to notice it too much over YouTube because it's just a small amount, but do it to the phase, for example. And I say, if you want to do this and you haven't got Zebra, you can do it through velocity and change the velocity to that. You could play around with sort of the detune as well, you know, map the detune to it so each detune is slightly changing each time. Multiple different ways you can kind of do things with this. But yeah, this is the type of thing that I do when I'm trying to create a nice sort of saw pad within Zebra. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I've missed off. You could add stuff like vibrato and stuff like that if you wanted to. Let's have a little isolation of one of these maybe. Let's go to oscillator 1. The could add a little bit of vibrato there. Adding a little bit of movement there. So yeah, I hope this has helped. As I say, if you are looking for more sound design courses, then be sure to head over to alamorastudios.com. There's a sound design tab, and I'll show you how I create other trance sounds in there. And if you also haven't yet checked out the AIM Studios trance production community, and you'd like to get tips like this sent directly to your inbox, then be sure to head over to alamorastudios.com/free. It's completely free to sign up. And yeah, as I say, exclusive tips and tricks sent directly to your inbox. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have done and you've taken some value from it, please let me know in the comments section below and give it a thumbs up. It really helps the algorithm and helps other people see the video as well. Or if you'd like to share it with your other trance producers friends, then please do that as well. Okay guys, thanks a lot for watching. I will see you in the next one.